This week's subject, things to do to remain safely retired. Are you retired or thinking about retiring? Is running out of money one of the big concerns you have when it comes to staying or being retired? Given the uncertainty of the economy and the markets, longevity risk is on retirees' minds. Although not often thought about, the reverse situation can also be an issue, getting to the end of life with a big pile of money and lots of unfulfilled dreams isn't pleasant either. So with these concerns in mind, here are my suggestions on how to balance retirement frugally with lifestyle enjoyment. First of all, it's important to have a budget. A careful budget can help you control spending to the level that is important to you to meet those long-term needs. Set realistic withdrawal rates out of your portfolio. A withdrawal rate is the amount of money expressed as a percentage of the portfolio that can be withdrawn every year. Now, that number changes depending upon the risk you're taking with your portfolio and your time horizon. Establish an emergency reserve. Certainly having money available in case an emergency happens gives people peace of mind. They don't have to go pull something out of a retirement plan, especially when the market is down. What about inflation? Have you considered the effects of inflation on that income you are going to have throughout retirement? You know, a 50-cent stamp today in 1958, 3 years after I was born, mind you, was only 4 cents. Be realistic. How much are you actually spending? Can this amount be reduced if you need to? What about healthcare costs? Have you considered that in your spending level? Social Security is also important. Picking the right time to take Social Security and developing a plan can certainly help go a long way in meeting retirement income needs. Consider working part-time. A lot of people do this. They don't retire right off the bat in a full-time basis. A lot of people will work part-time for a number of years before they retire full-time. That can certainly help with income levels later. Minimizing taxes is another area to consider. Where you take monies out of, whether it's a tax-free account like a Roth or a taxable account like an IRA or a little bit of both, distribution planning makes a lot of sense. Starting at age 70, remember you need to take required minimum distributions and that'll affect taxes as well. You certainly want to have some equities, stocks, in your portfolio in retirement to keep pace with inflation so that the portfolio does grow over a long period of time. Too much stocks, however, becomes too volatile for a lot of people. That doesn't necessarily work. Too little stocks doesn't keep up with inflation. There's a lot of research information out there on how to deal with preparing income for retirement. Also, if you need help, get some professional help from a certified financial planner. And as you can see, it takes a bit of work to stay retired and be happy, but it's well worth the effort for the peace of mind it can bring.